In this segment, I will talk some more about terminology associated to systems of linear equations and matrices. And the key notions we will discuss here will be pivot positions and pivot columns of a matrix. Now, the motivation for these notions is as follows. Remember that if we want to solve a system of linear equations, then the key step is to take the augmented matrix of the system and then to perform a row reduction of that matrix to obtain a matrix in reduced echelon form. Now, one of the main features of this reduced matrix is that it contains leading ones. And now the placement of these leading ones tells us a lot about solutions of the system of equations. If, after row reduction, we have no leading one in the column of constants, then that tells us that the system is consistent, so it has solutions. If we don't have a leading one in a column of the coefficient matrix, then this tells us that the variable corresponding to that column is a free variable. The problem is that if we would like to state these facts precisely, then they would sound quite awkward. We would have to say, for example, that a system of equations is consistent if its augmented matrix, after a row reduction, has no leading one in the last column. So, to simplify this, we have the following definition. We will say that a pivot position in a matrix is a position that after row reduction contains a leading one. In this our example here, after row reduction we have three leading ones, and this gives us three pivot positions in the original matrix, here, here, and here. The second part of this definition tells us that a pivot column of a matrix is simply a column that contains a pivot position. And so again, in our example we have three pivot columns, the first column, the second column, and the fourth column. And now, using these notions, we can state properties of systems of linear equations as follows. First, since a system of equations is inconsistent if and only if after row reduction we have a leading one in the last column, we can now say that a system of equations is inconsistent if and only if the last column of its augmented matrix is a pivot column. Secondly, as we know, free variables of a system of equations correspond to columns of the coefficient matrix that after row reduction contain no leading ones. So we can restate it by saying that free variables of a system correspond to non-pivot columns of the coefficient matrix. And lastly, since a system of equations has exactly one solution, if and only if it is a consistent system that has no free variables, then we obtain that a system has exactly one solution, if and only if every column of the augmented matrix of the system is a pivot column, except for the last column. It is now a good moment to take care of one unfinished business that we have that relates to systems of linear equations and their solutions. And this is something that goes back to the first part of these lectures. As you may remember, in that first part, I showed you, using some geometrical arguments, that systems of linear equations in either two or three variables can have either zero, one, or infinitely many solutions, and then I said that later on I would show you that the same thing applies in general to all systems of linear equations, regardless of the number of variables. And now we are ready to state this as a theorem. any system of linear equations can have either 0, 1 or infinitely many solutions. These are the only possibilities. Now, the proof of this theorem follows directly from what we did so far. If we have a system of linear equations, then we can take its augmented matrix, and then we can ask, is the last column of that matrix a pivot column? If the answer is yes, then that means that the system is inconsistent, so we have zero solutions. If the answer is no, then the system is consistent, and that means that we have some solutions. In this case, we can ask again, is every column of the coefficient matrix a pivot column? If the answer to this question is yes, then that means that we have no free variables and the system has only one solution. If the answer is no, then that means that we have at least one free variable and that gives us an infinite number of solutions. And now, as you see, this covers all possibilities. So this completes the proof of the theorem. Every system of linear equations will have either 0, 1 or infinitely many solutions. These are the only options. Now, later on, we will be returning several times to this theorem, and we will look from different perspectives at what it means that we have no solutions, or we have only one solution, or we have infinitely many solutions. This will lead us to several notions such as span, linear independence, dimension of a vector space, rank of a matrix, and these notions will help us describe and analyze these various situations. So this is something that will be coming later on. For now though, let me finish with one more fact that says that sometimes it is very easy to see if a system of equations can have only one solution or not. Namely, we have this theorem. If a system of equations contains more variables than equations, then such system cannot have exactly one solution. And here is why this is true. If we have an augmented matrix of a system of equations, then the number of rows of that matrix is the same as the number of equations of the system. And now the number of columns of the coefficient matrix is the same as the number of variables of the system. So when we are saying that we have more variables than equations, this is the same thing as saying that the number of columns of the coefficient matrix is bigger than the number of rows of the matrix. Now, every row of the matrix can have only one pivot position. So, if the number of columns of the coefficient matrix is greater than the number of rows, then we must have some column that will have no pivot position. And then this column gives us a free variable. And if we have a free variable, then the system cannot have exactly one solution. I should mention here that it may happen that a system of equations that has more variables than equations will have no solutions, since one of these pivot positions may show up in the column of constants, and then we will have an inconsistent system. But in any case, it will never happen that a system with more variables than equations will have exactly one solution, and this is what this theorem says.